Ziegfeld is a tribute to the life of the American theatrical impresario Florence Ziegfeld, whose follies were famous for girls, glamour and spectacular sets. This production at the Palladium contains many of those ingredients, but has been beset by problems in just its first month. A fortune was spent, up to £9,000, on individual costumes. But that couldn't save the show from being panned by some critics. And with changes required, the Canadian star Len Carreyrou suddenly announced he'd been sacked and walked out. The show's American director, Joe Layton, quickly followed suit.
I probably miscast Mr. Carreyrou. I think he probably plays even better a more heavy role. This is rather a light, frothy role to an extent. So I take that blame. And he has not been fired by me. It's a negotiated withdrawal from the show. He will earn a lot of money. His agent's on the way from New York now to discuss all those details with me. As far as Mr. Layton is concerned, very old pal of mine, brilliant director. I wanted certain things in which he didn't quite see.
Enter Tommy Steele, who directed and starred in Harold Fielding's Singing in the Rain, which broke all records at the Palladium, now back once again to save this show.
I'm very excited about it. It's a fabulous show. It just needs looking at, that's all.
It has, of course, had its problems. What do you think the future's now like for the staff, all the cast, and the continued production?
I think they're going to have a very good time.
He plans to cut the three-hour show by 20 minutes and introduce new scenes.
I believe Steele's contribution will just give it that little added edge to be absolutely right for 100% of the Palladium audience. Maybe at the moment it's right for 85%.
With £2 million in advance bookings, Mr. Fielding's optimistic that his enormous personal investment in the show is relatively safe. Meanwhile, the drama behind the scenes has been an unexpected bonus for Mark Urquhart, who steps into the lead role.
It's exciting, terrifying. I suppose it's the nightmare dream. It's the thing everyone goes, my God, if that could just happen to me, I'd really be spectacular. But it's a nightmare at the same time.
Now, though, the show needs an extended run to avoid becoming a huge financial folly itself. Marcus Powell for Thames News.